I am sure you have data which contains locational information. So let's learn how to plot data on a map. Click inside the data, make sure it's a table, then go to Insert menu, click on 3D map. Not this map, 3D map. Now it'll open a separate window and show you a globe. It did understand that LOC underscore name is actually names of cities and ST underscore name is actually a list of states. So it has already done it. But let's say in your case, it did not understand it. No problem. Click on add field. We know that LOC name is city. Open this drop down and make sure the correct geographical type is selected. As soon as you do that, it gives you some accuracy percentage, confidence level. Click on it and then it may show you some cities for which it has not understood it. So you'll have to repair the names or maybe add country as an additional column to resolve these issues. I'm also going to add state here, ST name, and it understood these are states. Right now, although state name is there, it has plotted locations, means cities. It has plotted everything, but it is not showing me the names. To do that, click on map labels. Hover, and then you will see the name of that particular point. All the names for every item are not shown by default, because if you do that, the map will get so crowded, you will not see the plotted items themselves. Anyway, now we want to plot our revenue or amount. So height and choose amount. This is all good, but we can't really compare the heights of the bars because we are looking at it from the top. So yes, I can zoom in or zoom out. Still doesn't help. I need to tilt. So I can tilt and rotate while zooming in and zooming out. A better way to do this is to press the Alt key and then drag using mouse. Now I want to change from city to state. Just click on this radio button and now it is plotting only the states. Right now we are only seeing it. Right now we are only seeing the geography and amount. I also want to divide these as a stacked column chart using type of card used. It does color coding. If you want to show the color coding, enable the legend. For now, I'm going to delete it. But it is difficult to compare individual items. So instead of a stacked chart, I want a clustered chart where I can see them side by side, which makes comparison easier. If I want to, I can convert it to a pie chart as well. And then we have heat map. But for states, what is a good idea is region. And now it color codes the region. It knows the boundaries and the color is determined by the value. So higher value thing is darker color, lower value thing is lighter color. We can customize all this from layer options. For example, I'm changing the color from blue to red and then it'll be shades of red. This is the overall picture, but I want to show this like one region followed by another region and at the end show this overall picture. Now these things are called a tour, visual storytelling. The first one which we are seeing here is a scene. By default, of course, there is one scene. Now in the first, I only want to show the southern part. I can also go to this sprocket or wheel gear and decide how long this scene will be shown. For demo purpose, I'm choosing just 5 seconds. Now I want to add another scene. By default, it will just be a copy, but I will want to show another region, let's say the western region. And like that, I will decide. Let's add one more for northern region and one more for eastern region. And finally, I'm going to add one more scene. Zoom out completely so that we can see the All India picture. You will notice that for each scene, we have these settings and there is some kind of effect. This is sort of a transition effect when it is moving from one part of the map to another part of the map. So I'm going to change each effect so that you can see available effects. First time it is circle, second it is dolly, which is a horizontal camera movement. Figure of 8, fly over, and because All India is being shown, I'm going to choose rotate globe. So now we have created a story out of this, and I'm going to play the tour. When I click on the play button, it goes full screen, uses the transition. Now from south, it is going to north. It's not just going to go there. It's a map. It's going to fly there. Stay there for 5 seconds, then move to the next one. And finally, it will use a rotate globe to show all India picture. If you want, this entire story can even be exported as a video. It'll be an MP4 file with HD resolution. So the last thing I want to show you is how to use the time dimension. When I click on the time, it's only going to show me date type of columns. So I choose the date. Why is this date being shown? Because it's the last date in my data. And if I scrub this here, notice what happened. This is the first date in my data. Right now, we are on the first date and only 2 transactions happened there. It has already plotted them. So I'm going to change this to 10 seconds. And I'm going to remove the effect so that you can focus on exactly what is being shown. Now, click on the play button. See what happened? It started with the first date. Very quickly, it's going through all my 1500 rows of data. And then it is plotting it. This is like an action replay of your transactions. So that was an overall picture. But suppose I want to investigate a particular area on a particular date or a time range. Zoom in there. Go to the intended period using this scrub bar and then drag this slowly forward or backward to scrub it. Maybe some event happened there or you had done some campaign and then you want to see its impact in that region in that time period. By the way, this is just a globe, but sometimes you have your own map. It could be shop floor, it could be a plot of land, it could be an airport. You can import custom map, plot the XY coordinates and put your data on top of it. For example, this video shows map of an airport and the traffic pattern. So what is the best practice? Don't wait for someone to ask you for a map-based report. Nobody is going to ask because nobody knows that this feature is there since 2013. Whenever you have locational data, just create a map, look at it, and I am sure you will find useful, insightful, actionable information from it, which you would never have noticed otherwise. So it's not just a great to have feature, it's empowerment. So that's it. Thank you.